having the options here of newbie to hard counter Alchemist in the laning stage.
Maybe they're thinking, if we aggro Trial, we're not winning our lane anyway, so we could aggro onto the Tide. Oh, he might be in
Snake
a trouble here.
In a lot of trouble. He can't move himself back. Kuro's got the body block off, and all that early harassment damage from GH did us work.
Should be able to slowly overtake him. Look at those boars tickling him. 5 damage per hit. It's, yeah, when he gets level 5, it's 0.
I'm actually just wondering, too, then, like if this rotation that Kuro made to the bottom lane, yeah, they're really going after Miracle. Have they got enough damage? He's still got the Acid Spray. He can pop off the Cold Feet. He's able to trigger Miracle. He's back underneath the Tier 1 tower. Couldn't even get the Acid Spray off. If he did, Yuwa may have died a little sooner, but it's still GH and Kuro doing the work. Pardai will make a break up through the trees. And Kuro's trying to stay on him. Has to walk off the Cold Feet. Deciding to actually walk towards the north, which means the arrow from MSS able to connect. Ven's on the way. They leap in forward, try and body block in Kuro. GH moving in forward too. Kuro is so low, he's got stick charges available. But GH, the Storm Ball, it flies forward. At least he got enough range to get out of the Cold Feet. The GH solo, another leap forward.
They're trying to put on some aggression here, but he's just too tanky now with these two bracers. The magic resist and the health should keep him alive against Jawar unless there's a great arrow coming in.
It's flying in. A little bit off target. The Cold Feet won't trigger either. Miracle's into the trees. Okay, but Jawar's going to stay with him. And Miracle blocked in. Has to cut his way free. MSS leaps forward. They're looking for him. Can't juke it out the tree line. But Weehar's adding a bit of pressure towards the mid lane. Kuro looking to try and help out to get the kill onto CC&C. Now, there is no Flame Guard available, so CC&C feeling a little pressured. It's back up the hill. Slider Fist tried to dodge that attack, buying a little bit more time with a phase boost, movement away. But no, it's going to be way too much with Weehar having that double damage rune.
That is very, very low value.
Because the 3 TP's happen, they realize that Miracle has no other support up on top lane, so Yuwa waits as long as he possibly can for the Storm Ball to fly out. Now you're searing chains, and if you need to, the Ravage will pop, and it feels like Snaking needs to, very liberal with the use. But they get the kill on Miracle and bring him down.
Watching the angle you come from, or if you are, you know, coming out of smoke or out of fog, it's a lot harder.
I'm loving this. I saw Weehar actually line up the BTs before. He's using the Beastmaster Hawk to get to the front lines, trying to wrap around the side.
Oh,
the Aurora's out over from CC&C. Snaking will create enough space with the Ravage, and now Beastmaster, he will fall. Weehar's caught on the wrong side of the tracks, so had a lot of help. It's on the way, but the Ice Blast will connect first. Pilot Eye will end up dropping to the attacks from down the low ground. Miracle once more with a Moonlight Shadow. They run away. Newbie was trying to contest these bounty runes once again.
I think that's pretty even, I suppose. It's 1-for-1, but Ravage was used, so you kill a core.
CC&C's back
Ravage
in. He's not done just yet. The Concoct is ready for Miracle, and they've actually got the control. Arrow flies forward. Everyone will dodge that one. No, they won't. Kuro catches in the back lines, so he's trapped where he is. Miracle will fall, and you shouldn't have said anything, Cinderin. Even, not anymore. This is going to be Weehar trying to battle for the last, but MSS has to leap and TP out. It will not be successful.
1-for-3 trade-off once again.
Yeah.
Alchemist seems like he kind of wants to go, but he has no Chemical Rage ready. So he's actually weak right now for this fight. He might try it anyway.
Well, Slide's already been used. Thunder God's Wrath. Mind Control's in a very, very bad position. Yuwar jumps in. He'll get the Roar off, but Mind Control runs away, but not fast enough. CC&C is the last physical bit of damage to attack through that BKB of Mind Control, and they're going underneath the tower. They really want to keep this push going with the Ravage clipping over on 3 with a Bloodthorn being used. Viper's down again. Weehar is a non-factor this game, and CC&C, he's everything. To the front lines, a double kill for Yuwa. GH will die in the tree lines. It leaves the last man standing, Miracle, still trying to farm up his Blink Dagger on the bottom lane. But Newbie can just go for Roshan. Just play it safe and get this first win against Team Liquid to start off their TI9 campaign.
What a great start to the day that would be for them too. You know, these groups, there's so much to play for in the groups. Step number one, don't get last in the group. Then you're already at the main event.
Yep.
And getting to the main event is worth...
The Bloodthorn's already out. Alchemist, he got Abyssal Blades. At least he's able to miss out on the arrow. Concoction beginning again. He's stunning the stun over on MSS. Mind Control, he'll arrive. What can he do? There's no Roar available. He can just give him a Medallion, try and get Miracle back into relative safety with the regeneration. It's still not going to be enough. And the Ice Blast, well, it won't hit Mind Control. That's the one upside from Team Liquid. Weehar again.
Die,
no, Weehar again. Moonlight Shadow, CC, and C just walks up. The Ice Blast is coming in. Weeha is totally dead. But then again, the initiation is the back lines. They find the Tidehunter, and have they got enough control? He's still got Ravage available. They just want to use it because the BKB is up. The Raw snaking, he would burn the cheese. He's got his life back again, and they're ready to Ravage with the stuns and the arrows to connect. Goodbye, Ogre. Goodbye, Alchemist. In just a second, if they can see him out, and they will be able to. Mind Control is trying to retreat back out, but you know the primary target is Miracle. He blinks. He's actually going to TP himself away. So they burn the Aegis to the Immortal, and now Viper, he's in a little deep, but they're still going up further north. They're looking for snaking. This battle is just splitting up every two different ways. The BKBs have been burnt. Weeha is finally going to go down. He'll bring MSS down with him, thanks to Viper Strike tick damage, but it's Alchemist. He doesn't have his Chemical Rage available. They have to force off him back underneath the Tier 1 tower, even with a bindback from GH. Now he may end up going down underneath his own Tier 1 tower too. So many heroes dead for so long, and Yawa, he wants more. He wants Miracle. The Chemical Rage is finally back off cooldown. So Miracle and Mind Control can retreat back to safety. Yawa, he's looking for the fight, and so is Miracle. Here's your first stun. The follow-up Abyssal Blade's available, and they actually do bring it down Yawa. Over 1,000 gold for the kill, and Miracle shows he's got some teeth. Keep your eye on Roshan. He may respawn in just over 2 minutes, so they've still got more time. CCNC. All right, the bait is there. Abyssal Blade to start this time around with a follow-up concoction. CCNC, they're going to bring him down. Buyback is available. And maybe they have enough slow, but here comes Yawa, the double stun with the Ice Blast. Everyone's in way too deep. They're all pushing him back, but CZNZ's buyback is there. Weeha stands not a single chance to survive.
Master X can be useful in the right situations. The Viper one can also be really good.
So how fast they do this? The Ember Spirit, Spirit's already in. CZNZ's gonna jump in. Questline of Fist Steering Chains. Snake King still looking for his right target to go for his own jump in, but Koro, the Ravage is out. Ice Blast on the way into Roshan. Who's going to claim it? Miracle gets the Aegis, the Immortal. Yawa, he's moved in. There's still cheese on the deck for the moment. Mind Control will grab it as Yawa. The Roar comes out. CZNC, the side of Fist, he actually dodges the pushback from the Roar, but they burnt the Aegis, the Immortal. Remember, it's on an Alchemist who doesn't have Chemical Rage available. Koro, not much more to give. He goes back inside the pit. He can throw out an Ignite, but you've already lost two heroes. Going to make it three as CZNC making the most of this Aghanim Scepter. Jumps forward, looks for the kill over on Beastmaster. The backlines can do its own thing as well, as Mind Control does go down with Koro. Viper underneath the Trine. He'll trigger it up. A triple buyback out from Liquid. My god, do they need something to make this worth it? Miracle! He stuns himself! He tried to actually just concoct TP out. Doesn't work. The Nimbus is barely off target. It's such a long time, but they're at least ripping through the creep waves. Arrow flies forward, it's a little too short. Now Miracle jumps in, looking for their own target, trying to bring down Sven. They're able to do so, dead for 100 seconds, and they want an extra chase. The Roar over an Ancient Apparition, looking for the supports. The arrow is tanked up by the BKBs. Now the double buybacks will arrive. Team Liquid just want to get back into their home, back into their base, but they just can't do it. The Ravage from Snaking clipped them all. 2 minutes down for such a long time on Miracle. Let all the stuns go you want, but without the buybacks, without the lives, this is what newbie wanted, a small opportunity to just try and take the rest of this base. A triple kill for CCNC. He wants the Ultra. He's looking towards Weeha and he'll claim him. The arrow flies forward. MSS will steal it, but that is GG. Newbie, they will be patient and take game one here.
I at least like this Pango leader, because now Liquid has like strong team fight, right? They have team fight to play against this IO Gyro. Pango is very good against IO, in my opinion.
I'll hope for it. At the moment, Team Liquid trying to contest for the Bounty Runes. Spirit's already out as GH will take all the bonus damage, but the poison's starting to stack up, soaking up the Rocket Barrage. GH trying to beat into MSS, looking for this kill. The Bounty Runes have now been put out, but GH, even with 5 stacks of poison, he doesn't care. He gets the first blood, turns around for a little bit more. They burn off so much mana of Yawa.
I think you can ask for much more in this lane for Legion Commander. It's just, it's not a winning battle. Oh, Astral from CCNC will secure the rune for snaking. Oh, nice call. Mind Control just barely getting him on the edge there.
It's down bottom lane though. That's where the real pressure is. SD Disruption's already out. Miracle wants to finish off Pilot Eye. The real one goes left while Weeha working with GH to bring down MSS. They're trying to get rid of the medic before they can get rid of Yawa. And even with the hit back with the swashbuckle, Yawa, the dive underneath the tower continues. The stomp snaking arrives. He gets a duel off. It's over on the Animage. No way to jump out. No way to use those 17 one charges that Miracle had ready to go. So snaking wants a little bit more of his own. Over towards Kuro team. Be up, able to be successful.
Half a second on disruption there. In rune Weeha had for this move. Low cooldown.
Snaking wants some help. He wants to go for the duel. Mind Control knows it too. CCNC's rotated over. TP is on cooldown for Mind Control, but he uses phase boots and movement speed to outrun for the duel. Snaking just gets in range. The axe will tick on down, but it's still not enough damage. but there's no other supporters down on bottom lane where the battle is actually going on. So Mind Control gets one quick roar off, but that won't be enough. Pylite Eye falling on the bottom lane. Noir, Frostbit, Nut, Miracle sticking on the back of this fight. That's the quickest way to get some, well, I say some money, but GH takes the double kill on bottom lane. Snaking and CC, and see no matter how hard they try, they can't find the kill, but now Pylite Eye, Weeha, will swashbuckle himself forward. Didn't want to go for the Rolling Thunder, but he would like to get a kill, not onto GH for once. That's his fourth kill of the game out of the eight that Team Liquid have claimed.
Yeah. Liquid's got to be really happy with X surviving this. He's going to ping it again, that OD's there. They're still not rotating to help him. He feels safe, and he is. So much space for Mind Control here. Mid lane. Yep,
GH. He's trying to work with him. Gyrocopter so much damage. Now the cooldown comes in. MSS returning to the fight with Pylite Eye. He's TP'd in. The duel is out. And GH, that's a big kill spree to end. MSS will claim it. It just seems the day that supports get all the kills. Yep. I go to the wrong side of the map. It's Weeha.
Okay, for
he
now.
Swashbuckle away. Starts with the Rolling Thunder and Disruption's out. And once he's going to come back into a quick jump away, the homing missile connects and Weeha will die.
Almost level 11 though. So it's a 2-level lead now for the Legion Commander. Yeah, this rune goes to CCNC. Goro is coming in to threaten, but...
Oh, he actually needs to instantly frostbite now, Mind Control. Yeah, doesn't want anything to do with snaking. Jumps in, Kuro gonna start to let it go, but man! The hammer drops, the relocate came in, and CCNC has himself a double kill.
And if the fights go long, I don't think Liquid are favored. I think they need to burst. Long fights, when Pangolty runs out, when the X call's expended, you're gonna die to the gyro.
Smoke's breaking. Mind Control. Blink gets the call off. Where Pylite dies. Snakey trying to break him free. Give him some extra life with the overwhelming odds. It's gonna work. And now, with the dual ET splitter, it hits back pretty damn hard, but they're gonna survive through it. Axe, he's so low on life, and he will go down. IO trapped inside the river with the Mana Void. They just bring in just enough damage to finish the job, but this is still a 2-for-1 trade-off.
He is still ahead of the Battle Fury Anti-Mage, minute 21.
Korok, Smoke's gonna break, Blink him. There's your first duel out, Legion Commander. Look at Panko, he is really killing himself, but they sleep him off. Panko needs to jump away into the Rolling Thunder. He'll get the jump out. You do drop the hammer from CCNC. The damage is enough to kill off CM, but now with Panko, we are back into the fight again. They have enough damage control on Snaking to get Miracle the kill on him
it.
And a triple kill from CCNC.
Oh!
Quick blinks away and Miracle's back up the road.
To get the kill off.
Great Observer to see so much. Sees Yuan coming up through the rune point. As we are trying to put this Agate Inceptor to work, just bouncing around everywhere. But as GH caught in the back lines, can't get the stomp off in time. The homing missile actually changing his targets overwards. We are caught inside the cooldown. So he'll go down to the dual combination, and letting it go allows Mind Control to TP away to safety.
They could definitely be a possible upper bracket team from this group.
They are hunting. Here comes Mind Control, in for the call. MSS is there for the tether. Have they got the damage to kill up the Gyrocopter with Mind Control's Blade Melt? They do. They burn through the Aegis Immortal, but Duel is out, and Animage, he turned it around with the Spell Shield. It still doesn't matter. AM is still dead. Mind Control can't run himself away from this, or can he? With the Shield Crush down? No, he can't. Yuan's got himself a double kill. CCNC wants his own. They're waiting for Weeha to get out of that Rolling Thunder so they can go on him again with a defensive imprisonment. Weeha still can't finish the job on Sneaking. Finally, he has a double kill down, but so is the cooldown. Weeha will get out of range for the second missile, but not the homing one. Pango will fall. Buyback is available. GH couldn't help him out anymore.
But yeah, he got that guy instead. It's also another good kill. X is once again slowed down. Bounties are coming up.
Oh, the blink in from CC.
He didn't know.
He still got plus 32 intelligence in hits with the Sanity's Eclipse. Miracle. No way he can survive that. Kuro begins his own TP out to safety. He'll be okay.
There's an SD with a save. There's an OD with a blink save. I can tell you from
experience. Oh, Axe! Hoi! Oh, Mind Control. This may be his ninth death.
Swing
he turns on the Blade Mail, but Yuan's on the chase. The homing missile's coming as well. The cooldown, well off target. Mind Control not protected anymore. The Glimmer Cape is worn off, and Yuan just goes for the double kills. Moves out, goes after Kuro, while Anti-Mage gets trapped a little bit further down. Weeha banished. He actually got the Thunder off, but no, he doesn't. Down he goes with a double kill.
Mid lane, instead of coming to help his team. But in the end, like, his game is just extremely difficult, and he has to go for his team. Who else is going to engage?
Yeah.
Like, at some point, you gotta jump, right? If you're not letting the enemy team totally control the game.
Kuro's going to engage. He jumps in, goes for the Frostbite. This thing takes so much damage, he's almost going to die from this. And maybe with MSS, though, he just yield dodges. Weehaas jump forward. The ET Splitter hits on nothing. But Miracle does get the back lines, killing a pylon.
Oh, he hits himself.
Pulsing out the buyback. But there is the Hex out, and they got the control. CC&C so damn low. He's actually got not enough life. Or does he? Still alive. Weehaas. Okay, that's how they get his enough life. Liquid just die. And then there's no more damage to be done. Kuro will let it go. But this is 2-0 in favor of Noob B. They start off their TI9 campaign with a hell of a lot of strength.